Hello everyone, thank you for joining me today. To those of you that are new here, I do have quite a few subscribers that have joined me, so thank you all. For those that are new, my name is Terry, and I do focus mainly on pen reviews, particularly fountain pen reviews, and I also will do an occasional art video here and there. I've been a passionate pen nut since as long as I can remember. But in today's video, I'm going to review and compare M-series Pelicans. And I also have this vintage set here too that I'll talk a little bit about, but I'm going to focus mainly on these three M-series pens. So I'm going to go ahead and get the vintage set out of the way. So this is an M140. I'm sorry, not an M140, just a 140. This was first introduced in 1952 and it was produced until 1965. This is a piston filler and it does have a 1.5 mil capacity. So pretty impressive for a pen that was produced back in the 1950s and 60s. It does have a nice 14 karat gold nib and this is a extremely flexy 14 karat gold nib, and it is an extra fine. And I'm going to write with these in a bit. And this is the pencil that came with it, and both of these were $121 on eBay, so pretty inexpensive. And the pencil is a mechanical pencil, of course, and does have it uses 1.18 millimeter lead. Pretty nice pencil. Has a nice eraser there, so it's nice, easy to use. And you normally in a mechanical pencil, the eraser would be here, and you would do like that. But they put it in there, which I thought was a good idea. So nothing on the top finial there, and just the lid there. And it has the green stripes. Matches this nicely. Although this looks, compared to this, no, I guess they're the same. This just looks a little blue-green to me. But this is in pretty good shape. I really haven't had to do anything to it. The piston is still very smooth. I don't know, it may have been restored before I bought it, but it does work pretty flawlessly. There's a little Pelican at the, is that a Pelican? Yeah, Pelican at the top finial there. It's a little hard to see because it's all black, but there is something engraved there. And just a pointy finial, nothing spectacular there. And on the band, it just says Pelican Germany. And on the pencil, it's the same thing, just Pelican Germany. Oh no, this says Pelican 350 Germany. And the ones that I'm going to focus mainly on are my M series. And here we have the M600. This is the M600 Souverain Tortoiseshell, Red Tortoiseshell Limited Edition or Special Edition. This is the M800. This is the black and red version. And this is the M1000, the flagship, I guess. And this is in your typical green striped version. So I am going to start with some writing. I've already wrote a little bit just to save time. This video may be a little long because I do want to take my time and kind of deep dive into my thoughts on all of these pens. So to get the Pelican 140 out of the way, again, it's a nice flexi nib. But when you write with it normally, it is pretty firm. if you don't put any pressure down. It's pretty firm. It's a very scratchy in reverse. It is a little scratchy, I would say, the right way around. I do need to think smooth this a little bit. But very nice pen, and again, very good value for $121 with the pencil. But yet, I really like this pen. Again, like I said, I just need to smooth it a little bit. It is a what I would consider a true extra fine, and you know, compared to Pelikan's nibs normally, they're pretty much on the broad side. But this, I think, feels like a typical extra fine to me. But again, it has that nice, so you go from a really extra fine to, you know, medium, fine, a medium, on up to, I guess, a broad, double broad, I would say. So very, very diverse, flexible pen there. I think this is good for someone who just doesn't want to pay a lot of money for the M series here. They're a little pricey, and you want a nice, reliable, flexi pen, a nice vintage pen. This is a very good option. And this was my second. I bought the M600 was my first Pelikan. And this is these were my second. So, and the pencil is just, you know, typical lit mechanical pencil. Pretty thick line. But let's see. The vintage, so I'm gonna get those out of the way and just focus on these three. So this is M600 Souveron limited edition or special edition red tortoiseshell, and it is kind of on the smaller side. It is bigger than the 140. But it's not really, definitely not a pocket pen, but it is on the smaller side. It's a pretty good size though. I can write with it comfortably unposted, but typically for this pen, I do post it. And you can see it has that beautiful Pelikan nib there. So beautiful nib. And this is a 14 karat gold extra fine nib. And on the finial, top finial, there's just the Pelikan and one chick, but you can't see through it. It's not translucent, but there's the tortoiseshell pattern. It has some orange and red and I guess brown to black, and yeah, very nice pen. This is also a piston filler, and it has a 1.65 mil capacity. And this is according to Goulet Pens. With every pen they sell, I think pretty much they have a spec section, tech spec section, that they put all the specs for the pen. And they say it's a 1.65 mil capacity, which is actually oddly more than these two. So, I don't know. I don't know how that is. Maybe there's a lot of wasted space on the inside of these, but according to Goulet Pens, it has a 1.65 mil capacity. And I'm going to put the specs on the screen for all of these. And I can believe that it does have a 1.65 mil capacity, because I rarely fill this up. And another good thing about it is that I can leave this inked for weeks at a time, months at a time, and come back and it always starts up. There's never any hard starting or anything, so it's very reliable. And this I bought on eBay for $392. I bought this from a overseas seller. I think it was like 308 British sterling pounds or something like that, and it translated to $392. The Goulet pens, they're selling their M600 red white special edition for $512. But the price on eBay for this one is pretty much around $350 dollar mark. So you can save quite a bit of money. Not that I'm saying don't support, you know, your local retailer, but if you're money conscious, you can save quite a bit of money on eBay. So this nib is pretty firm. This really, I would say, not much line weight variation. It does put down more ink when you push down on it, but I wouldn't say it has an incredible amount of line weight variation. And it does okay in reverse, a little scratchy, but not bad. And this, although it's an extra fine, it is, I would say, a pretty thick extra fine. And that was one reason, that was the main reason actually, that this pen took me quite a while to come around to. I was just like, I just don't care for this pen at all. I don't know what it is, but I tend to write more with fine points and extra fine. Occasionally I'll get a medium. So when I got this extra fine, I was disappointed that it wasn't what I consider a true extra fine. But it has grown on me just because of the way it writes. It's just a smooth writer. I just approach it now not expecting it to be my typical extra fine. When I sit down to write with it, okay, I'm expecting it to be a medium. But, I mean, it's just super reliable. It's lightweight. So if you have smaller hands, this is, I would say, probably the best. I don't have any of the 400s or 200s, but of these three, I would say that this probably was the most comfortable to write with when I did my transcriptions, and I'll show you that page later. So that's the M600. M800, this is like in the middle. This is a fine 18 karat gold. And this one has a 1.52 mil capacity according to Goulet Pens. According to Pelikan Collectibles, I think that was the website, this one has a 1.5 mil capacity. So all of these are pretty much around the 1.5. And this was on eBay for $405 from a US seller, which I thought was a pretty good deal. So this also has although it's a fine, it pretty much writes like a medium. I was kind of hesitant to get the fine because I thought it was going to write more like a broad, but this writes like a medium. So I was pleasantly surprised by that. The seller that I bought it from only had mediums. A little skippy in reverse, but not bad. And again, just like the M600, it puts down more ink when you press down on it, but it's not really a flexi pen like the 140. But overall, I would say this one is probably, I think this is probably my favorite based on the looks and the size. I think this is, for my hands, this is just pretty much perfect. But I'm going to rank these, and I'm going to rank them in real time. I haven't done it before, so we'll see if this is really my favorite according to the different factors that I have here. But that's the M800, and you can see there's red and black stripes. They also have a blue one that looks pretty nice as well. Again, you have the check at the top finial, and it just says Pelikan Souverän Germany, and the M600 says the same thing on the band. And you have the two gold bands there that look really nice, and your piston knob, and again you have this beautiful nib. Oop, beautiful nib and the feed. And lastly, we have the big one. This also says on the band, Pelikan Souverän, Germany. The famous green and black stripes, also with two bands at the piston knob there. And this nib here, look at this one. It's a big nib. It's an 18 karat gold, also fine point, beautiful nib. Just beautiful. There's the feed. And this has a 1.51 mil capacity according to Goulet. So this one has, of these three, for some odd reason, it has the least capacity for ink, which I thought it would have had, you know, more than all three. And in my transcriptions, I wrote in my little notes that this has a good ink, large ink capacity based on what I thought. It's a good, still a good ink capacity, but compared to these smaller pens, it has less, which I guess is due to some kind of inner workings that I'm not familiar with. But there's the writing, and there is the flex. It does have a very nice flex, but based on reviews that I've seen, it is emphasized not to push this, because apparently they are prone to springing if you do push them. They're not intended to be flexi pens. But it does write nicely in reverse, and it has a similar line weight to the other two. It's a, looks like a Western medium to me. But it does have a lot of nice spring to it. It is not a firm nib, it is a very bouncy nib. And this was on eBay for $529. Goulet sells it for $832. And for the M800, which I paid $405, they sell it for $656. But that is the beautiful M1000. And so now I will show you my transcriptions. So this is how the this is how the 140 looks. And it's inked with Diamine Aurora Borealis. So you can see it's a very nice extra fine with some nice flex there. And these are some of my thoughts when I'm writing. I wrote it post-it and I said it's very nice. It's a, what I consider a true extra fine, but it's a little toothy and it felt a little bit dry at times, but very comfortable to write with. And the M600. This is inked with Diamine Writer's Blood, and I also wrote with this post-it, and it says it feels great, and it was very comfortable to write with. And I wrote, this is my right hand, and this down here is my left hand. And it felt pretty comfortable with both hands. Same with the 140. And here we have the M800. And you can see it's quite a bit thicker, but not bad. Not bad at all. I was able to get everything on the page comfortably. And it was pretty comfortable to write with. I didn't put any notes here, but those are my thoughts from what I can remember. And here we have the M1000, which is considerably wetter, but still I was able to get everything that I needed to get on this page without any issues. But you can see it puts down a lot of ink. And I think this was my right hand, and this down here is my left hand. My left hand looks a little, I don't think I wrote too well with this with my left hand. I don't think I like the flex with my left hand as much. But that's how it looks with the transcriptions. And so now I'm just going to give my overall thoughts, and then I'm going to try to rank these. Oh, before I do that, I will show you how they look in the Yoseka log, the nib log. And I keep saying I need to get new paper for this, and I definitely do, because it does not provide a good representation of the wetness scale. But this is the 140. I said it has a 0.35 millimeter line weight. Again, this is some of my thoughts, so you can see the flexiness there. Nice, extra fine, toothy. It does need smoothing, and I'm going to do that in a little bit. It's comfortable, lightweight. I think, like I said before, an excellent value, lovely flex, and it's a lovely vintage pen. And you can see my line weight comparison. And we have the M600. And this is from I did do a review of the M600 several videos back, so if you want to check that out, feel free. So this is the writing from that video. And I said it's a noisy wet nib. It just have a little bit of, on certain papers, it's a little squeaky. But I still like it. I said it's lightweight and comfortable. Of course, it is thick for an extra fine. It's a lovely pen, quality construction. All of these M series, they feel like they're built like tanks. I mean, they are solid pens. So the M800, it's inked with Monteverdi Mercury Noir. And there you can see the wetness. The wetness, it wasn't very wet here, but it is a pretty wet pen, I would say. There's a softness testing. And I have here thick, fine, smooth, comfortable, built like tan, but needs to be tank. And the nib has some bounce when pushed, but definitely not like the bounce that you see in the 1000 or the 140. And in the line comparison chart, I said this is also a 0.6. So the extra fine of the M600 feels pretty much like the fines. So the 1000 is inked with Mont Blanc Irish Green. It's again a fine. I also said this has a 0.6 line weight. And you can see it's a little bit more wetter than the 800, and also considerably softer than the 800. I said flexy, but be careful, as I said before. It is wet, it's smooth, comfortable, and solidly built. So my comments for them all are, I would say, pretty much the same. So to sum up and to do this comparison of the M series and give my overall thoughts. So these are my initial thoughts. So I'm saying here that the M600 is the most comfortable. It's a little pricey when you compare it to the 800 and the 1000, although it is less expensive than the other two, considering that it's an M600. You would think that it would be considerably less expensive, but it's pretty much the same as the M800. And I said it's a thick, extra fine. And this was written with the 140. The M800, I said, in my opinion, was the best value. It's comfortable, and it's a nice fine. The M800, and I'm basing my values on the price that I paid on eBay. I'm saying it's a good value. It's a nice fine. It's chunky. It's a chunky pen. I definitely wouldn't post the 800 or the 1000. You can. And it's a chunky pen, but I still think it's comfortable. And that's even with a sprained thumb. I still find it to be comfortable. And you can post all of these. You know, this is definitely doable posted. I definitely wouldn't post the 1000, but these two are definitely postable, and I prefer this one posted. So now I'm gonna rank these, and like I said, I'm gonna do this in real time, just off the top of my head. So I'm gonna rank them, you know, first, second, and third. So the pen with the lowest score is going to be the top ranked. So for value, I think the M800 is the best value for me based on what I paid. And I would say the M1000 based on what I paid is the second, and the 600 is the third. Comfort, the 600 is by far the most comfortable for me to write with, and the M800 is next, and the 1000 is third. Now, writing experience, which one do I like writing with the most? Actually, I think this one, I'm not including this one in this ranking, but this one's probably the one that I enjoy writing with the most. I'm going to say the M600 is the best, and 800 or 1000. I kind of like the bounce of the 1000, and I think I'm going to say for me, for writing experience, I'm going to say, it's kind of, I wonder if I could tie these. Now I'm going to say the M1000 because of the flex. And the M800 is last. And nib, and I'm talking about the way the nib looks and feels, I would say. The M1000 has the most beautiful nib of the three, and it's I'm gonna say that's number one. And I'm gonna give, I think I'm, because I like big nibs, I'm gonna base this on the looks of the nib. Other I have here, I have the looks of the pen, the flex, and the ink capacity. So, looks, flex, and ink capacity. I think as far as intangibles, the M1000 beats these. The 600 has to come next because it has that 1.65 mil capacity. So I'll put that next. And then, so that's it. So this has 9. This has 11. And this has a 10. So, the M1000 comes out on top. Followed closely there. So you see they're all close. So that's not really one that really outshines the other. They're all pretty close, and my opinion may change. So number one was the M1000, number two was the M600, number three was the M800. So I wish it was more definitive than this, but they're all pretty equal. They're different, but at the same time, they're kind of the same as well. So those are my thoughts. All four are excellent piston filling pens. Kind of different, but the same at the same time. So those are my thoughts on the M600, 800, and 1000, and the 140. If you have any questions about these pens, feel free to put it in the comments below. I do answer everyone. And if you have a longer question, or if you don't want to put it in the comment section, my email is on my YouTube page somewhere. And so before I go, I will point out this book, this Pelikan and special limited and special editions book, and it focuses on pens from 1993 to 2020. I bought this from Pen Boutique. This was $100, quite pricey, but good if you want to know about the history of Pelikan and look at some of their special editions. So it definitely, if you read through this, it does make you want to buy more Pelicans. But just a beautiful book. I love the photography in this book. I love reading books on pens. So I have a few books, a couple of Andres Lambro books, and I have this one here. So if you can find this, the prices kind of vary on this book. I think it goes up to like $125, but I did buy it for $100. I don't think Pen Boutique still has this one. They have another version, like the History of Pelikan. They had that one, I think it was $72. So I may check that book out at some point as well. But I'm really enjoying my Pelicans. I don't plan on really buying any more. These are the ones I'm pretty happy with. Maybe a 400 at some point, but maybe a blue one. But I'm pretty happy with these. So again, thanks for all of you for watching my videos and for commenting and taking the time out of your day to watch and to like and everything. I do appreciate it. I never ask for people to subscribe and like and all that, but I do appreciate everyone that does take the time to watch my videos and comment and everything. So I do take this pretty seriously because I do get a lot of emails and questions in the comment section about my opinions on particularly the E95, the Pilot E95S. I get a lot of questions about, you know, fine versus medium versus extra fine. So I do take my reviews very seriously because I know some people are going to take what I say and go out and buy these pens. So I try to put a lot of thought into my reviews here. And although I may be a little dry, but I do not as probably as entertaining as some reviewers, but I love pens and I really do enjoy doing these videos. So all of that out of the way, thank you all for watching and I will catch you next time. Take care.